back to my YouTube channel. It's still your favorite sophisticated. Let me put sack. Yeah. Sack shagala. Yeah. Sack shagala. Sack shagala. Sack sack shagala. Sack sack shagala. How are you? How have you been? Afra. Guys, guess what? We're gonna be gisting today. Yeah, like we're gonna be gisting. Gist, guys. So, guys, so I'm going to be gisting you the story behind this, my traveling bag. Did you see very well? Yeah, this is my traveling bag. So, guys, hey, Shagala's absorbed in Jennifer's voice. Like Shagala's observed in Jennifer's voice. So guys, this is what happened. Not to take too much of your time though. Yeah, guys, like you see this this story I'm about to tell you, like I want to ask your opinion. Like, what would you have done if you were in this kind of situation? What would be your reaction? Yeah, and would you take, like, would you use this to take your luggage back to your country when you are going back? Would you use this to take back your luggage to your country? So I think that's the question, right? So let me start the main gist. It all happened like this. Was it not last few months? Yeah, I think before I started my YouTube channel. Yeah, it was before then. It was before then. I was doing some extra unnecessarily work with my boss. No, I was forced, like, use the word forced, because she forced me, like, some, you know, all these people with their wallah, they have problem, like, just cleaning unnecessarily. So, I was forced to do some unnecessary work with my boss. We were cleaning, there's one part in our compound like that, as we used to put some useless things like spoiled bicycle, instead of them to throw it away instantly, they will first put it there as if they are keeping a dead body inside the mortuary. They will first keep it there, maybe spoiled bicycle, teared balls, you know, this football something, teared balls, they will put it there. See, all unnecessary things, they will share a pussy instead of them to throw it away. They will be like, maybe we are still going to need it, and at the end of the day, they are not going to use it. I don't know their problem. When I la mojukuro, I don't know how to say it in English. I la mojukuro lubanjekeri wepo is one of Yoruba saying. So so as I said, like, we were tidying up that place, and we were about to finish, and the next thing I heard was I was even about to go and throw away the bin. So I heard my boss called, like my madam, she called me Rukoye, because my Muslim name is Rukoya. So, but yeah, they don't call it Rukoya, they call it Rukoye. So like, she called me and I was like, what happened? So she asked me to take this sack. It is not this sack in particular, but it is this type of sack, because the sack she asked me to take them. It was very, very dead, like very, very dead. So so she asked me, she gave me the sack and said, I even thought she wanted me to dispose it. So I collected the sack and I was going to the bin, and she called me back and said I should wash the sack. I was like, wash this sack again? It won't waluf, like this people get problem. So she asked me to wash it. After washing it, like I should take it to my room and put my belongings, so that, like, I should use it to pack my belongings when I'm going to Nigeria. I was like, is this woman kidding? So I thought she maybe it was a slip of the tongue. Okay, so I said, mama. She said yes, that she said I should take it and I should wash. After washing, I should take it, like when I'm going to Nigeria, I should put my belongings there. I was like, and the sack was very, very dead. Like, we have kept it, like we've kept the bag for a very long time. I couldn't even remember how long it have been put there. Like, it is very, very, like, for a very long time, guys. I was speechless. Like, I was really like, as in, take sack to take my belongings to Nigeria. But you see that day, like, I was very, very stressed, like I was tired. So I left the sack there, then I went to dispose my bin. So when getting back, I did not even bother to take the sack. I left it there. So because in my mind, I was like, when I'm going to dispose the bin, the second morning, I'm going to take it along with me. So when I finished disposing the bin I wanted to dispose before, I came inside my room. After maybe like few minutes, she knocked my door. I was like, what happened? So she brought the sack to my doorstep. She said, I forgot this. I was like, so this might really mean what she's saying. Hey, so like I never went, so I collected the sack from her, then I went to put it inside the washing machine. So I already know what I'm going to do in my mind. So I didn't even bother to argue with her because I was very, very tired that particular day. So I went to put it inside the washing machine, then I came back to my room. So upon getting to my room, I was thinking, what did this woman take, or like what did she take me for in particular, as in telling me to take this kind of bag to Nigeria, like carry these guys? Like I was like, is it intentional? And it is intentional, because if it wasn't intentional, she wouldn't have brought the sack to my doorstep. So it is intentional. So I told one of my friends, and she was like, really? Sack of rice? Ah, you come on, take care. Hey. And guys, sincerely, it wasn't her fault, because assuming I was not working like a model, yeah, because that day I was very, very tired, so I wasn't working very fast. So assuming I was not working like a model or working as if I'm passing on a red carpet, maybe that wouldn't have happened, because I was surprised. How would somebody ask me to use this kind of thing to take my belongings back to Nigeria when I'm not going back to the village? Like, is this... Sincerely, guys, like, this is actually very, very funny. Before, I didn't find it fun. I find it annoying, or being looked down on. Maybe they are looking down on me because I don't even understand. And I came here safe. I didn't use this type of thing to bring my belongings. So how would you expect me to take this? Even though if somebody don't have saving safe, it is not like using this type of thing. Ghana must go is even preferable. Oh, this? Hey guys, like I told you that shagalas have suffered, sincerely. And the thing is, they can never use this, never and ever. And guys, you see this sack, and the reason why we used to keep it is we used to use it to cut fish or laham so that it will not stain the floor. That is what we use this kind of, and she asked me to use this to take my belongings. So guys, that comes to the end of today's gist. So like, guys, what would you have done if you're in this kind of position? Like, would you have shouted at her? Because I know when I'm going home, she's going to ask of this sack. Yeah, she's going to. I don't even know what I'm going to reply her with, but one thing I know is I can never use this kind of sack to take my belongings back to Nigeria. So guys, what would you have done if you're in this kind of situation? Like, would you use this kind of sack? Not even this kind. Would you use this sack to take your belongings back to your country or what? So guys, let me know in that comment section. Maybe you can use this type of sack to take your belongings back to your country. Or what your reaction would be if your boss did the same thing to you. So guys, that is the two questions I'm going to pass to you all. And please guys, don't forget to give your opinion under the comment section. Let's laugh. Sincerely guys, this is actually very, very funny for me, like very, very funny, sincerely. So guys, don't forget to put down your opinions under the comment section. Yeah, don't forget to put it down. And thank you guys, thank you for giving me a listening ears. Like, I really appreciate you guys, I really appreciate your support guys. Please don't forget to share the video and give this video a thumbs up. Like guys, we really need a lot of subscribers. Yeah, we need it. Please guys, I'm begging you all, share to your friends, family, even your enemies, sir. Even your enemies, sir. Share to all of them. Yeah, let's grow guys. We need a lot of subscribers. Yeah, we need it. So guys, thank you all for, like, thanks for your time. Like, I really appreciate. thank Don't forget to click on the subscribe button if you haven't done so, guys. Much love. Let me show you my traveling bag. One more time. Areko Wolu. It is not Areko Abi. Ara Oman Wolu. Can you get it? Bye guys, have a nice day. See you some other time. I love you all, like I cannot take your love for granted.